Understanding how climate change is affecting the world can be really overwhelming. There's a lot of information from many sources coming at us fast and often. How do we wade through the rising sea of information? One way to explore climate change is through music. Here at the Science Museum of Virginia, we wanted to highlight the effects of climate change over the last 800,000 years. We picked four natural phenomena that show how our planet's climate is changing: sea ice, temperature, carbon dioxide, and species diversity. Graphs of these data were then translated into sheet music, one for each instrument. A violin, viola, cello, and double bass come together to form the Climate Quartet. Let's take our double bass and go back 1,500 years to explore Arctic sea ice. We start with 10 million square kilometers. The sea ice grows in size as it freezes with the cold weather, then melts as the seasons turn to warmer spring and summer months. As this cycle rises and falls over and over, the volume of sea ice never strays from between 9 and 11 million square kilometers, until the last 100,000 years. As technologies advance and population skyrockets, Arctic sea ice rapidly melts, with levels plummeting below 8 million square kilometers. Layers of ice from the last 800,000 years reveal changes in carbon dioxide concentrations over time, as played by the violin. Each bubble trapped in the frozen water perfectly preserves the atmosphere at the time the ice was formed. With the fluctuations of carbon dioxide frozen in time, we can see, and now hear, rhythmic cycles of increasing and decreasing concentrations every 100,000 years. This cycle was interrupted in the last 100 years, with carbon dioxide levels soaring to unimaginably high levels and no relief in sight. But how do we really know what temperatures were like? The trees and viola will tell you. Trees have rings, and not only do they document age, but they give us clues about how temperatures change. In trees that mainly depend on temperature to grow, narrow rings in trees indicate slower growth and cooler temperatures, while wider rings indicate faster growth during warmer periods. The music pitch gets lower as temperatures are cooler than expected, and higher when it's hotter than average. Musical pitch rises abnormally from 1850 onward in the face of steadily hotter than average summer temperatures. Last but not least, the cello will highlight human impact through the number of species extinctions over the last 250 years. As the demand for food, energy, and resources increases with an ever-expanding population, humans not only develop areas that force other species to relocate, but do so at a rate that's not sustainable. Species that fail to thrive in changing habitats go extinct. Globalization and technological advances rapidly increase from 1900 onward, and so do the number of species that go extinct. Now that you've learned about each musical thread, close your eyes, open your ears, and listen to the interwoven sounds of the Climate Quartet. What can we do to help the Earth in the face of a rapidly warming climate? The Science Museum of Virginia has been active in raising awareness about the impacts of climate change through studies of urban heat islands and air quality, while communicating climate science through interactive exhibits and programs, and greening our campus to create a more sustainable future. Thank you for watching, and be sure to come visit us and add your voice.